Welcome to analog communication playlist. Here in this session I'll be going to explain Costas loop receiver for DSBSC demodulation, and this session that I'm preparing based on request of one student here on my channel. So let us begin this session with first point of basics of Costas loop receiver. Now see, whenever you have coherent detection, at that time at receiver end carrier is required, that should be phase coherent with transmitter carrier, and then only you can be able to demodulate that signal in coherent detection. It can be possible if we transmit carrier component with modulated signal. So if you want carrier detection, then coherent detection is possible by having a transmission of carrier component with modulated signal. But if you see DSBSC signal, then DSBSC signal is having suppressed carrier, double sideband suppressed carrier. So in DSBSC there is no carrier component. So as there is no carrier component, coherent detection by having separate carrier signal it is not possible. So in Costas loop it has capability to generate coherent carrier at receiver, and therefore demodulation of DSBSC signal is possible. So I'll explain how we can generate carrier signal which is coherent to received signal, and how we will be demodulating that signal. That is what the complete session that I'll explain here. So let us start with this, with block diagram. So if you see the block diagram of the Costas loop receiver, you can bisect this block diagram into three parts. One is I channel, second is Q channel, and third, this, that is what, error signal generation. So this is how we can bisect this complete block diagram: I channel, Q channel, and error signal. Now see how it works. Here you will be receiving DSBSC signal, and DSBSC signal is AC MT cos omega CT. So this DSBSC signal, that we give it to I channel as well as Q channel. So this DSBSC signal, that we will be giving it to I channel as well as Q channel. Now see, here there is product modulator. This product modulator, that will multiply this DSBSC signal and this output of VCO. Now in I channel, output of VCO, that is directly given to this product modulator. But in Q channel, after having phase shift of minus pi by 2 phase, we give it to this second product modulator. So if you see this VCO output, that is A0 cos omega CT plus pi. So that is what we are giving it to product modulator 1. So multiplication of DSBSC and VCO output, that is V1T. And here after having pi by 2 phase, this A0 cos omega CT plus pi, that will get translated into A0 sin omega CT plus pi, and A0 sin omega CT plus pi, and this ACMT cos omega CT, that is what we are giving it to product modulator, and it will generate V2T output. Then after V1T and V2T, both will get passed through low pass filter 1 and low pass filter 2 respectively, and it will generate V3 and V4 output. And here you will be receiving modulated signal, and here V3 and V4, that is again given to another product modulator. So error signal ET, that is multiplication of V3T and V4T, and based on error signal will be having ECT signal, and that ECT signal will justify what will be a frequency and phase which is there with voltage control oscillator. So voltage control oscillator, that will be generating frequency component based on input signal, and that input signal is ECT. So ultimately working of this Costas loop receiver, that is happening like, see, V1T, that is multiplication of DSBSC signal and A0 cos omega CT, V2T, that is multiplication of DSB signal AC MT cos omega CT, and A0 sin omega CT plus phi. And after having these two signal, we just pass it through low pass filter, and that is what generating output signal. And here error signal will be multiplication of I channel output and Q channel output, And based on this error signal, V0 will generate frequency and phase of coherent generated signal. Now see how it will be coherent generated signal, that we will be observing over here in working of it. So let us start with working of Costas loop receiver. So see, the voltage control oscillator produces waveform whose frequency is controlled by input voltage ECT. So VCO output is completely based on input error signal ECT. The output frequency of VCO when ECT is 0 is known as free running frequency of VCO. So if error signal over here, that is 0, in that case output of this VCO, that one can say it is free running frequency. So obviously our aim is to run this VCO at free running frequency, and that will happen only if this error signal is 0. So if this error signal, that is what multiplication of V3T and V4T, if that is 0, then one can say VCO is working at free running frequency. Now let us observe this combination step by step. Now see, as I have told you, V1T, that is what multiplication of DSBSC and this A0 cos omega CT plus phi, and V2T, that is multiplication of DSBSC signal, that is ACMT cos omega CT and A0 sin omega CT plus phi. So let us observe how signal will appear and what will be error signal based on it. So we will be considering first case. So in first case, let us assume frequency and phase of VCO output are same as that of incoming carrier. So in that case, frequency and phase is same. So phase, actually if you see over here, VCO output, that is A0 cos omega CT plus phi. So as frequency and phase of this VCO is same, phi will be 0. So you can see output of VCO, that is A0 cos omega CT, and phi is 0 here. So in that case, V1T, that is multiplication of DSBSC signal and A0 cos omega CT. So if you multiply this two, this is AC A0MT into cos omega CT, cos omega CT. So that will be cos square omega CT, and cos square omega CT is 1 plus cos 2 omega T plus 1 plus cos 2 omega t by 2. So here that will be AC A0MT by 2 into 1 plus cos omega CT. So there are two components, and you can see one component is this AC A0MT by 2, and second component is AC A0MT by 2 into cos 2 omega CT. Now see output of low pass filter. See, then after this V1T, that we are passing it through low pass filter 1. So output of low pass filter 1, that is V3T, so it will remove high frequency component. So these are high frequency component, and that will get removed. So output of low pass filter 1, that is AC A0MT by 2. And similarly, we can have this combination for V2T, where V2T is multiplication of A0 sin omega T plus phi into DSBSC signal, that is ACMT cos omega CT. So this two multiplication will result into V2T, and if you observe here, V2T is this, and this is what cos into sine. So cos into sine, 2 cos sine is equals to sine 2 theta, right? So AC A0MT by 2 into sine omega CT, and here again we are passing this signal through low pass filter. So after passing this through low pass filter 2, you will be getting V4T. And here there is no low frequency component, all frequency components are high frequency components. Output of low pass filter 2 will be 0. So if you calculate error signal, so error signal is V3T into V4T. So here error signal ET, that is V3T into V4T, and as V4T is 0, error signal will be 0. So here there is no error signal, and if error signal is not there, in that case you can say output of VCO, that will be in phase with incoming carrier signal. So it will be A0 cos omega CT. Now let us assume second case, and in second case, if I say it is non-phase synchronized signal, So in second case, if it is non-phase synchronous signal, VC output, that will be A0 cos omega CT plus phi. So now, because of phase synchronization is not there, you can say this VC output, that is A0 cos omega CT plus phi. So in that case, we will be doing same process again for V1T. So that is what? DSBSC signal into output of VCO, and that will result into AC A0 MT by 2 into cos 2 omega CT plus cos phi C into C, that is C plus C. So there are two frequency components. This is high frequency component and this is low frequency component. So as this is high frequency component, if you pass it through low pass filter 1, this will get removed and you will be getting output of low pass filter 1, that is AC A0 MT by 2 into cos phi. And now same thing that will be doing it for V2T, where V2T is DSBSC signal into A0 sin omega CT plus phi. As we know, this VCO signal that we pass it through pi by 2 phase, so this cos will get translated into sin, and that is what we will be multiplying by product modulator 2. And as you pass it through product modulator 2, these are two frequency component, C into S, S into C, that is 2SS, and as per that, this high frequency component that will get cancelled as if you pass it through low pass filter, and your output will be AC A0 MT by 2 into sin phi. So see, output of low pass filter 1, that is V3T, that is AC A0 MT by 2 cos phi, and output of low pass filter 2, that is AC A0 MT by 2 into sin phi. So these two outputs are there, and that is what we multiply at error signal. And as you multiply this, you will be finding our error signal, that is V3T into V4T. And if you multiply this, you will be finding it is 1 by 8 AC A0 MT whole square into sin 2 phi. So this is what our error signal. And as if you pass it through low pass filter, let us say this is constant. So C is equals to 1 by 8 AC A0 MT whole square. So that error signal will be this, and our output that will get controlled as per this error signal. So output of VCO that will get controlled with respect to this error signal. So this DC component of controlled voltage ensures that the VCO output is coherent with the carrier used for modulation. So here VCO will be coherent with respect to the signal which is getting modulated, and that is how we generate our output. So this will happen till this VCO is working with free running frequency. So in first case, as I have told you, at free running frequency this error signal will be zero and you will be receiving MT into some constant. So we can be able to demodulate our signal over here. So this is how this Costas loop receiver functions. I hope that you have understood this. You can give your valuable suggestion. Definitely I will get back to you based on it. Thank you so much for watching this video.